Hey there, Tim Bauer here from LiveVideoGuitarLessons.com with a practice tip of the day. This was for the advanced player, and this is installment 5 in our series on working tonic chord sweeps into our pentatonic scale work. The other 4 are already over on the website, www.LiveVideoGuitarLessons.com. I'll have this one over there after a while, and I'll probably shoot one more, wrap it up with a half dozen, and I'll have that last one over there in a couple days. Anyway, so today I want to work with tonic chord sweeps on our low strings, our bassy strings. I want to work in major keys with major pentatonic scales. And we're going to do E form and A form. Okay, so let's just jump right in. Oh, and real quick, the way I'm, when I'm working in major pentatonic scales, I'm usually converting that major key down to its relative minor. It's just easier for me to keep straight that way. And like, so if I pick key E flat major, it works out the same. But instead of playing E flat major, I'm playing C minor, the scale position for C minor. It's just easier for me to keep straight that way based on the, I did a lot more minor pentatonic work in the music I grew up playing. It's just easier for me to keep them straight. But like I said, it works out the same no matter how you think about it. So anyway, so let's just take that. We're gonna play our tonic chord here for E form. We'll start on my E flat here, and we're just gonna play tonic 1-3-5. So that gives me my tonic E flat chord. And you'll see it points right to position 1, C minor. So you can just kind of sweep that in there. You wouldn't do that many sweeps. I'm just doing it for demonstration purposes here. When you're learning how to do it, you want to do a lot of sweeps to get used to the motion. But if you're playing in front of an audience, you might want to kind of hold it down and sweep still. Think you're a little overboard with them. All right, so let's do A form real quick. My E-flat note on my A string is here, and I'm going to do the same shape of tonic chord. That's 1-3-5. You can see it points right to position 4 for C minor. So I can do kind of, it's almost the same shape, almost the same motion, just shifted down a string. So I just get over here. So anyway, hopefully that helps. Just kind of make sure you have some music turned on when you do that, so you can hear how what you're doing plays against the chord progression in the song you're playing against. And thanks for tuning in. Tune in again tomorrow for another practice tip, and I will see you soon. Thanks.